All right. So it's a few days later, and here is our ginger bug that's going. I'm going to go ahead and stir it up a bit. I have a couple things I wanted to show you. This is a spoon straw. So you see it's a straw that has a spoon on it, and it's reusable, which is kind of cool. This is a mate straw for yerba mate. Yerba mate. It's a metal straw. Una bombilla. That's what they call it. Yeah, that Argentine, Uruguayan Spanish has kind of got an Italian lilt to it a little bit. Or swing. So I can link to these if you want, stuff like this. It's nice. You don't need it. Colander's nice. I actually got this one on Amazon. I'll link to that as well, along with the mate straw. So we're going to want to strain all the solids out of the ginger bug. If I were to stir it a bit, you can see it's going to bubble. And that means it's still working. We're still happy. But there's all those solids in there. Now with a mate straw, you could just drink it if you want. But I'll go ahead and give it a sip and just see kind of what it tastes like now. Woo! Woo! That's strong. Love that ginger. And it's still pretty sweet, I think, because it's concentrated. So we're gonna wanna water it down somewhat, but we're also gonna wanna strain out the solids. Now I'm gonna keep this going. And I'll show you how I'm going to do that. There's many ways you can do it. This countertop's clean, by the way. So I'm just going to use a colander here and put the ginger bug here into the pitcher. Now the rest of this stuff, the solids, I'm not going to throw them away. Ooh, because I'm going to get another one going here. There's lots of good, healthy, living culture in all of this. Fiber, all this ginger fiber. Okay, I'll set that over here. And so to get that going again, I'm just gonna get some more. You wanna guess? You wanna guess? Brown sugar and water. you could add more ginger if you like, but it looks like the culture is nicely on its way now. So I'll just add some of that, and I'll add a little bit of this. How much? I don't know. I'll just guess. And guess what? Voila! I've got another ginger bug here. I'm gonna go set aside. In fact, maybe I'll do an update on how this puppy looks. And we'll see how it survives this kind of transfer. Okay, so now we have, based on my sense of taste, we have a base. We have a concentrated kind of ginger ale solution. So I don't wanna, I'll just give another sip here. And you know, I'm just kind of like drinking from the straw. It's my own. This isn't something I'm gonna like manufacture. So in terms of like, well, what about germs and sanitation? It's just a family, home, personal thing. I'm not as worried. Woo. Yeah, that's strong. So what I want to do with this liquid is I want to dilute it. I want to make it taste like something I want to drink. I'll try some water. You could also, and you could have done this before, but add lemon zest or lime zest and the juice. Don't put the seeds or the rinds. I had this sitting in the fridge. Very important thing, if you're going to add something like this, look at the label. And what I see here is sodium metabisulfite preservative. Uh-oh, sodium benzoate preservative. Uh-oh, if I were to put this in here, it might kill the culture, and I don't wanna do that. So I'm not gonna use this. It's very important. Same thing if you use juice. Just look at the label. If it says ascorbic acid or ascorbic acid, I don't know how to pronounce it. It's just vitamin C, that's fine. But any sort of metabisulfite, benzoate, sulfites, stuff like that, sulfates, you don't want that because that's going to kill your culture. Okay, so I just added some water and it was already pretty sweet, so I'm going to see what it tastes like now. Okay, it's not bad. It's a little mild. So I'm going to add a little more sugar. And I'm using brown sugar, but you could use raw cane sugar, you could use white sugar, you could use juice. You could use anything sugary, really. It's entirely up to you. Again, if you add it, if it has some kind of preservative, just be aware it's going to have the possibility of killing the culture, and you won't get any more fermentation or less. You get less fermentation, a weaker fermentation. And if you want to carbonate it naturally, which is what I'm going to show you how to do, that's not going to work either. So I'm going to give this a whirl. That's not so bad. Now the ginger flavor is a little bit weak because at this point, if you really want to scale it up, you could do more ginger to add more ginger flavor, but I'm going to keep this one pretty mild. And so now I have it kind of where I like. I'm just going to pour it. Oh, hold on. There we go. Into this bottle through a funnel. The bottle is self-capping or self-corking, you might say. This bottle came from Trader Joe's. They have every holiday time, they have a seasonal ginger ale. I took the label off, and I might show you in a video how to do that real easily. And I got a bunch of these bottles. I love them because they're reusable. So it's not full all the way, but I don't mind. I'm going to go ahead and cap it like that. Oh, someone's at the door. And I'm going to leave it at room temperature. But you see this is glass and it's corked. I'm going to check it very frequently by opening it and getting a sense of how the carbonation is. If it carbonates too much, guess what? This thing's going to blow up. And nobody wants an exploding bottle. So I will do that and I'll show you as I do that. Stay tuned.